Hi, I'm Joe. I'm 29. I live in Denver, Colorado right now. I decided to come to Namekagaya and participate in the ayahuasca ceremonies back in November. I had felt like over the last few years I had done a lot of work on myself to, for lack of a better phrase, integrate my experiences with depression and the struggles I had throughout my childhood. And I'd found a lot of peace and meaning through martial arts and some light psychedelics throughout my life. But back in November, I was really, really struggling at work. A lot of things in my personal life had coalesced at the exact same time to just when it rains, it pours kind of thing. And I had been interested in ayahuasca for probably about a couple of years. I had heard a lot about the variety of transformations people have had with it. I think especially I'd heard a lot of testimonials around mental illness stuff and getting over addictions like alcoholism, food addiction, and just a ton of different things. And what stood out to me was a lot of the testimonials that I saw on the Namekagaya site, as well as from like podcasts and other like more popular celebrities that have done it, was the ability to forgive and the self-compassion that came afterward. And for, I guess that really, really spoke to me. And, I realized I was just struggling a lot with my own self-narrative at the time, and this was oddly like the light at the end of my tunnel to get me through the next several months, both in work and in the stuff that was unfolding in my personal life. I've seen everyone transform here in all very positive ways. But I'm also hesitant to say, like, oh, anything is totally cured or fixed. They say certainty is absurdity. So I'm being very, very patient to say like, oh, I've solved this, or I figured that out, that other thing in my life, or I think every relationship I've had is going to be repaired. But for me, the highly abstract definition I have of what I do here, or what I did here, what I'll continue to do, is being really comfortable with the uncomfortable. I don't think I understood what I was getting into until the very first ceremony. And you do it at night. I didn't realize that. And at the same time, it feels like the experience is pretty similar to other psychedelics I've done. So I found a lot of overlap between mushrooms and a little bit of that overlap with MDMA, and acid has never personally done anything with me or for me, so I can't really speak to that. I had never taken a psychedelic at night, and while there's a lot of similarities, I would also say this also feels stratospherically different. Just doesn't feel like, oh, this is a psychedelic and a medicine second. This very strongly feels like this is a medicine first and maybe a psychedelic second to those who don't want to consider it that way, or don't share that vocabulary to think of it that way. Well, the first ceremony, there was a lot of fear and anxiety and honestly at times terror. Like I had no idea what I was about to experience. You hear a lot about the phenomenon of purging, and purging I've come to appreciate is a very abstract term. It's not just vomiting or diarrhea. It's yawning, it's giggling, it's crying, it's screaming, it's even at times like flailing about. But there's probably dozens of different kinds of purging that ayahuasca encourages you to do. And my first ceremony wasn't pleasant, but it wasn't unpleasant either. I definitely felt the effects of it, and there were some strange visual patterns. Like I saw the serpent. I didn't really know what was going on. None of my thoughts or emotions really made much sense. But I was very grateful. I think I was one of the two people at night that didn't really purge. And it lasts a long time. I probably feel the effects 10 or 11 at night, and it goes like through the next day. I think the intense parts of it probably wrap up about anywhere from like 3 to 5 or 6 in the morning for me, but it all varies personally and your dosage and just your own personal experience with the medicine. The second ceremony was I took a much heavier dose. A lot of the same fear and anxiety, but it felt a little bit more familiar for me the second time. I also didn't purge on that one. But that one was incredibly intense. It felt primal, it felt visceral, it felt. At times it was pleasant, like I was fascinated by my life and my narrative and the memories I had and the relationships I had formed. But that was really, I think, when it started to. We started to work on getting comfortable with the uncomfortable, surrendering to the medicine. And then the third ceremony was when I took my largest dose. That one was a lot more pleasant, but it was incredibly strong. And I found that as the ceremonies went on, the visuals would build on top of each other. Not in terms of exactly what I was seeing, but just like a lot of colors, a lot of patterns, a lot of shapes I couldn't understand or explain. And they described the third one as like the soul surgery. So that felt pretty accurate. It felt like I was revisiting every memory I ever had and looking at it with compassion and patience and like a lot of love and awe. And from every memory, we were like stitching together this narrative of myself, of trying to find the patterns and the archetypes of who I am, who I was, who I will be. That was just the whole night. I don't have the words to really describe, what is the end result of that now. But overall, the third ceremony was very, very positive. And then the fourth ceremony almost like an afterthought, like, oh, I don't really want to do this. I feel like I've gotten what I wanted to out of this experience. I talked to Matt and I was like, can we like lower the dose? I want to be able to like go to bed before 5 a.m. That'd be really nice. So we did, and overall it was a lot gentler on the body and the mind. But as Matt also says, like there's ego in thinking you can kind of control how the experience goes. While it was gentler, there was a lot of plenty of uncomfortable things that I worked on with her. And I would say, like, the fourth one didn't really give me a ton of clarity or stitch everything together, but it was a good way to be a final ceremony. The staff here are really good. The volunteers, the facilitators are exceptional at just being incredibly accommodating and patient with you and holding space for you, and everything that you do outside of the ceremonies really help you to process what's going on and ground you in this reality. Yeah, the jungle is the perfect metaphor for everything that's going on here. The connection I felt to the animals, to the people here, and the conversations that I had, the love and affection and yeah, fascination I had with everyone and everything here. I haven't felt that way maybe ever. Very difficult to do justice with words of what happens here and what ayahuasca is or who she is. But I feel my relationships with people, with animals, with insects, with food, especially. I struggle to envision a future where I'm going to want to drink alcohol again. Yeah, integration is a really cryptic word, but that is what I did here. Integrate like the darkness and the lightness in yourself and to see them as one and the same and different at the same time. And to look at the darkness in yourself with a lot of love and compassion as well. Yeah, I would say I suspect this is certainly not for everyone. I doubt it's for most people. I suspect this is a good medicine only for a minority of people. But the minority of people who it's a good candidate for, this is a lot more than just a catalyst for change. As strange as it sounds, I felt the call to come out here, to be close to the source of where the vine is harvested, to be in the environment where the vine grows. You're asking yourself if it's right for you. I would say if any part of you hears the call, listen to it, do your research. There's a lot to consider. But don't ignore that call.